Hey everyone, and welcome back. In our last video, we showed you how to turn a tiny Raspberry Pi into a device that can act like a keyboard for some clever pranks. But that was just a preview. Today, we're not playing games. We're going to use that very same device to perform a much more serious attack, gaining unauthorized access to a locked Windows machine and stealing a top secret file. Are you ready to see just how vulnerable your computer can be? Let's go. Critical disclaimer alert. Before we go any further, I need to make something absolutely clear. This entire demonstration is for educational purposes only. We're doing this in a controlled lab environment, on a system I own and have full permission to test. The goal is to show you how a physical access attack works so you can understand the risks and protect yourself and your systems. Never, ever attempt this on a computer you don't own or have explicit permission to access. Unauthorized access is illegal and has serious consequences. All right, with that out of the way, let's break down the script we're using. This is a very clever payload that exploits a specific Windows feature to run a command prompt with administrator privileges, even from the login screen. It's often called a sticky keys attack because it takes advantage of the accessibility feature. Let's walk through the code so you know exactly what's happening. First, we get an admin shell. The script uses a Windows shortcut to open the run dialog and then launches PowerShell with administrator privileges. This is the critical step that gives us the power to change system files. Next, we gain control of the target file. The script targets sethshay.exe, the sticky keys executable. It modifies the file permissions, giving the current user full control so we can make changes. Then, we make the switch. This is the core of the attack. The script copies cmd.exe, the command prompt, and replaces seth.exe with it. It's a simple xcopy command, but the result is a powerful new backdoor. Finally, we clean up. The script exits the PowerShell window, leaving no trace behind. The ultimate goal of these commands is to privilege escalation or to establish a backdoor. By replacing sethka.exe with cmd.exe, an attacker can trick the system into running the command prompt with elevated privileges whenever the ease of access sticky keys feature is invoked. This is because sethka.exe is executed by the system at a very early stage of the boot process, even before a user logs in, and with high privileges. When someone presses Shift 5 times on the login screen, the trigger for sticky keys, seth.exe would normally launch. However, because it's now cmd.exe, a command prompt window would appear with administrator privileges, allowing the attacker to execute any command. In our last video, Pawn Pi Aloha Part 1, we covered how to set up the auto run feature, a crucial step for what we're about to do. If you missed that and want to know how to get your Pawn Pi Aloha device to automatically execute a payload as soon as it's plugged in, be sure to check that video out. You can click on the I button in the top right corner of your screen right now to go directly to that video. I highly recommend you watch it first, as it lays the foundation for today's demonstration.
Okay.
Now with that said, let's get into the fun part. Imagine this scenario. A victim leaves their desk for a quick coffee break or to use the washroom. They've forgotten to lock their computer, and in their absence, it's completely vulnerable. It only takes a few seconds for an attacker to walk by, plug in a device like this, and plant a backdoor. The attacker leaves, and the victim returns, completely unaware that their system has been compromised. The attacker now has a way to get back into the system at their convenience, perhaps at night, or on a holiday when nobody else is around. This is the power of a quick, physical access attack. The stage is set. The backdoor has been planted. It's now a few days later, and our attacker has returned. The victim is not here. The computer is on, but it's at the locked login screen. Now, the attacker can easily trigger the backdoor they planted. And there it is! By simply pressing the Shift key 5 times, we've launched our payload, and it has opened a command prompt right over the login screen. Windows thinks we're just using an accessibility feature, but we've now gained full control without a password. With administrative privileges, the attacker can now move on to their objective. First, they can create a new user account with administrator privileges to ensure they have a consistent way to access the system in the future. We can do this with a simple command net user hackerman supersecret password slash add. However, a newly created user is just a standard user. To get full control of the system and access sensitive files, we need to make our new user an administrator. We'll do this with the command net local group administrators hackerman slash add. And just like that, our new account has full administrative privileges. With this power, the attacker can log in and access any sensitive document in any user account on this computer. They don't need to be on the victim's account to find what they're looking for. For example, our top secret folder is on another user's account, and we can now open it with no problem. And here it is, the top secret document. As you can see, the most sensitive information a hacker could find is not always what you expect. We've just hacked the system and found a funny picture of the world's most wanted hacker, Crazy Panda, on vacation with his boss's wife. It just goes to show you, sometimes the biggest secrets are the most ridiculous. After a successful exfiltration, a skilled attacker would delete the account they created to leave no trace that they were ever there. How to protect yourself? Now that you've seen how this attack works, you might be asking, how can I protect myself? The good news is, these are all preventable attacks. Here are some key takeaways. Lock your computer. The simplest and most effective defense is to always lock your computer when you walk away from it, even for a few seconds. A simple Windows key plus L is your best friend. Disable unused USB ports. In a corporate or sensitive environment, you can configure your system or network to disable unused USB ports. This prevents any device from being plugged in. Disable sticky keys. Since this attack exploits a specific accessibility feature, you can simply disable it. Go into your Windows settings and turn off sticky keys to remove this vulnerability. I hope this demonstration opened your eyes to how a simple device can become a powerful tool for physical access attacks. The key takeaway is simple. Never leave your computer unlocked and unattended. By being aware of these vulnerabilities, we can all practice better digital security. This knowledge is our best defense. If you found this video informative and want to continue the PwnPiloa series, please write PwnPiloa Part 3 in the comments section below so I know there is interest. Be sure to like and subscribe for more ethical hacking content, and I'll see you in the next video.